Are there any treatment options for destroyed skin from CO2 ablative laser? I had only mildly noticeable lines around my mouth and mild acne scars. CO2 took out all my pigment. Think ghost. Destroyed skin laxity, pitted and left acne-like depressions all over my skin. Skin is waxy, dimpled, mottled, dehydrated. This procedure destroyed my skin, and it's progressively getting worse. This is the reason why the late review. Are there any treatment options to help improve my thinning skin? Circadia moisturizer seems to help some.
Thank you for your question. You submitted several photos and you describe in your question that you underwent CO2 laser, which resulted in having a significant loss of pigment, describing yourself as a ghost in appearance, and the fact that it left you with a lot of pitted acne-like scars, and you're looking for some type of solution to help you with improving your skin quality. Well, I can give you some perspective from my practice, a little background. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and a fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic surgeon, and I deal a lot in New York City, where I've been in practice for 20 years, with people who have had various thermal-related trauma to their skin from aesthetic devices. Unfortunately, your situation is a little more unusual in terms of CO2 laser. This was a situation we actually trained with the CO2 laser back in the mid-90s. And at that time, the CO2 laser was very aggressive, it was ablative, it was very, created a lot of heat, and unfortunately a lot of people had complications. So it actually led to almost an abandonment of the use of CO2 laser for many years by the majority of colleagues until the fractional CO2 lasers came in a couple of years ago, and in my practice, I used the fractional CO2 laser a lot. I will tell you that my perspective about how to rejuvenate skin has evolved over time as I've developed methods related to regenerative medicine using some more developed modalities that build tissue using your body's own natural abilities. And what I'm referring to is the use of something called platelet-rich plasma. Now, platelet-rich plasma is derived from your own blood. And you can learn a little bit about it by doing a literature search in the National Library of Medicine or PubMed so that you can see that there's a lot of work done with platelet-rich plasma. Interestingly, in the cosmetic field, a lot of people are not aware of it, I think mainly because there's no big pharmaceutical or laser company promoting it. But when you realize that in the modern time that a lot of people are getting overheated with whether it's a laser device, as what appears to have happened with you, or a thermal device which is supposed to create non-surgical skin tightening, people are realizing that they're losing skin quality, the skin is getting thinner, it's often becoming effectively scarred, and they're losing fat under their skin. So what we do in our practice is we use platelet-rich plasma to try to stimulate the blood supply to the skin, to stimulate the fat cell layer under the skin. In fact, when it comes to acne scars, we use platelet-rich plasma a lot. We have had a lot of success with combining platelet-rich plasma with hyaluronic acid fillers to give long-term, more permanent improvement of acne scars. So I think that from my perspective, I would suggest considering platelet-rich plasma as a way to help you improve your skin's appearance. Platelet-rich plasma is not a one-time treatment. I always describe it like the way you go to a gym to build muscle. You treat and you observe the result and then you treat again. the difference with platelet-rich plasma compared to thermal devices is you're not heating the skin. You're actually stimulating the quality by increasing blood supply and improving and increasing collagen. Basically, you're manipulating the wound healing mechanism that our body already possesses, and you're leveraging that to improve skin quality. I have consistently seen benefit with platelet-rich plasma in my practice for dark under-eye circles, for acne scars, as I mentioned before, for scarring, for skin quality improvement, like complexion improvement. People who don't have any problems with a trauma or will come in just for skin quality improvement, because facial aging, there's loss of collagen, loss of blood supply. You do platelet-rich plasma and the skin gets this remarkable and unique glow to it from the treatment. So I think that that's something that I would suggest. Certainly, there's some topicals may be of value, but when there's been ablation, I think that really tissue rehabilitation is the way to go. I would avoid any other type of thermal devices. I don't think you'd pursue that anyway. But certainly, it's unfortunate that you've had this result. But I think that there is some value to this. Now, other ideas also include fat grafting and adipose-derived stem cells. But since those are more surgically focused procedures, while platelet-rich plasma is simply a blood draw and a treatment the same day, if you think about a strategy where you treat, you observe, and at some point there may be a plateau, that may be the time to consider a surgical option to enhance the benefit. And of course, whenever we do fat grafting, we also use platelet-rich plasma to improve the outcomes in that situation as well. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.